Hi, I am Sridhar R from Government Women's College, Tumkur. Today, I am going to demonstrate an experiment prescribed by the Tumkur University for second semester BSc Physics. The name of the experiment is Series Resonance. Our aim of the experiment is construct series LCR circuit and to determine the self-inductance of the coil, resonant frequency, bandwidth of the circuit, and the quality factor of the circuit. So now we will demonstrate the experiment, the series LCR circuit. The equipments required or the apparatus required for this experiment is the audio frequency oscillator, inductance coil, capacitance box, resistance box, milliammeter or the multimeter. Multimeter or milliammeter, anyone can be used. Now, to demonstrate the experiment, so we required all these apparatus. What is the principle behind this experiment? So when we give the frequency of the audio oscillator to the LCR circuit, the reactance of the inductor and the capacitor changes. At some frequency, reactance of the inductor is equal to the reactance of the capacitor. So that is XL is equal to XC. So when this XL is equal to XC, the circuit will offer the minimum impedance. So therefore, the current flowing through the circuit is maximum. So when the XL is equal to XC, if you rearrange the terms, so XL is equal to, you know that 2 pi FL, that is omega L, and XC is equal to 1 divided by omega C, that is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi FC. By equating that, if you rearrange the terms, you will get the frequency. The frequency corresponding the reactance of the inductor is equal to the reactance of the capacitor is called the resonant frequency. So the resonant frequency you will get FR is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi root LC. To calculate the bandwidth, you have to plot the graph at which the difference of the frequency has to be taken at I maximum, maximum current divided by root 2. So you will get F2 minus F1 is the bandwidth of the circuit. And quality factor is equal to FR is the resonant frequency divided by bandwidth F2 minus F1. To calculate the inductance of the coil, L is equal to 2 pi F 2, 1 divided by 4 pi squared FR squared C. So here this one is also be calculated using XL is equal to XC. So therefore you can calculate the inductance of the coil using this relation. So now we will see the circuit. See, this is the circuit. Here the inductor, capacitor, resistor we have to be connected in series. To this series we have to connect a milliammeter. This is a milliammeter. For this milliammeter we have to connect audio frequency oscillator, AFO or AO, audio oscillator or audio frequency oscillator. So in our experiment, we use the function generator for an audio frequency oscillator. Now I will connect the circuit. You can see this is the function generator and this is multimeter, and here this is inductance coil, the choke we are used as an inductance coil, and here this is a capacitance and the resistance. We are connected the inductor here, the two terminal inductor here and two terminal capacitor here and two terminal resistor here. We are connected all these three in series. To this we are connected the function generator or audio frequency oscillator. So positive terminal, so this red terminal heat connected to here, and the neutral terminal we are connected to here. To this series circuit, we are connected the multimeter. So this multimeter we used to measure the current. So in the place of milliammeter, we used the multimeter to measure the current. So here the positive terminal of this multimeter is connected here, negative is here. So this is the circuit connection. So now this function generator shows the frequency here. By varying the frequency, we have to be measure current, the current flowing through this circuit. So this is the knob we use to vary the frequency. So you can observe here. So by varying the frequency in step of 100 hertz, you have to be measure the current flowing through the circuit. This display will shows the current in the multimeter. You can note down the readings. So now the table is, the tabular column is here. You can see this is the tabular column, very simple tabular column, the frequency versus the current. By increasing the frequency, you can note down the current. Here the current is in milliammeter. So now let us take that some trials. So by varying the frequency, I keep the frequency to 100 hertz. So exactly you can keep the frequency 100 hertz. Okay, so no problem. Okay, so 99, it is nearly 100 hertz. For this 100 hertz, this multimeter shows 0.22 milliamps. You can write the 0.22 milliamps in the tabular column. So now I will write 0.23 milliamps. So similarly, repeat the experiment by changing the frequency to 100 hertz, 200 hertz, 300 by increasing in step of 100. You can observe the multimeter reading, the current, it is increasing. You can observe, so as the frequency increases, the current is also increases. At some frequency, the current will be the maximum. You can observe 2.29, 2.39, 2.5, 2.8. So 2.86 is the maximum. So for the 700, about 700 hertz, the frequency, the circuit will offer the minimum impedance. So therefore, the current flowing through the circuit is the maximum, 2.86. If you increase the further, the frequency, if you increase further, you can observe current is drops. After taking all the readings from the 100 hertz to 1000 hertz, by note down the current in the tabular column, and after that plot a graph of the current versus the frequency, you will get the curve like this. The maximum current, ilane maximum current by the in curve, so that is the I maximum. The frequency corresponding to the maximum is the resonating frequency. So I maximum n value one ide, that divided by root 2 maadi. So here you got the 2.86. 2.86 divided by root 2, you will get some value less than that. 2.86 kinta kadme barutte. So you can mark here. From that, draw horizontal line. It will cuts the curve at two points. So first point cuts the curve. So from that point, you have to draw a perpendicular line to the x-axis. The second, from the second point to the x-axis, you have to draw a perpendicular line. The first point, the frequency corresponding to the first point is the f1. This is the f2. These two frequencies are called half hour frequencies. So the difference of these two frequencies will give the bandwidth. Okay. So by using this data, so we are connected the resistance 1 kilo ohm and the capacitance 0.5 microfarad, and L we have to be calculated. This is the unknown we have to be calculated, because here we use the choke. So therefore choke may have the 1 Henry. So therefore using these relations, you can see, using these relations we can easily measure resonating frequency. FR is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi root LC. Bandwidth also, and also quality factor, and finally inductance of the coil L is equal to 1 divided by 4 pi squared FR squared C. So using these data, we can easily calculate all those things, and finally we can write the result.